Now, there were no reported casualties from the Iranian attack on the U.S. military base in Iraq on Tuesday. In fact, there are some sources that are saying that the U.S. knew about the attack plan in advance. Our Yoon Jung-min tells us more.
Following Tuesday's attacks by Iran on two Iraqi air bases housing U.S. forces in retaliation for the killing of General Qassem Soleimani, sources say the U.S. military had advance warning of the attack. The Iraqi Prime Minister's office has said its Prime Minister Adel, Abdul Mahdi was briefly told by Iran's Revolutionary Guards about the attack plan. CNN said the U.S. seemed to have got the information ahead of the attack from their sources in Iraq, while others said the White House was preparing for the attacks several hours before they happened. U.S. President Trump in his briefing said no death or injuries resulted from the missile attacks. Rather than a strong military response, he only pledged powerful economic sanctions on Tehran until Iran changes its way. An expert says that has now opened the door for the conflict to be resolved through dialogue.
And the fact that the Iranian attacks did not result in U.S. human casualties, that means that Mr. Trump was not going to escalate. And as you pointed out, he chose to send a message of firmness, of confidence, banking the win that he has achieved by killing Mr. Soleimani, but at the same time extending a hand to Iran for restarting negotiations about the nuclear file, but also about other issues.
The expert emphasized what's more important is that Trump has left much room for the nuclear deal with Iran.
More importantly, restarting negotiation within the P5+1 framework, which Mr. Trump has been opposed to until now. He has always favored bilateral negotiations between the U.S. and Iran, but now he seems to have changed his tune.
She went on to say that Iraq was stuck in the middle, something that Baghdad definitely did not want. While the Iranian attacks would have made it more difficult for Iraq to kick out U.S. troops, which its parliament had voted to do. Yoon Jung-min, Arirang News.